Welcome student to DSS online classes. And in my last class, I sent you a PDF. And in that PDF, I have given you the structure of chromosome. Today, I am discussing the entire structure. What is the peculiar structure of chromosome? Here I have shown you the nucleus, and inside the nucleus of the cell, the chromosomes, they are in form of fine thread-like structure, and these fine thread-like structures, they are known as chromatin fibers. Here I have shown you the chromatin fibers, and these chromatin fibers, they are highly coiled. Since DNA is in form of thread, and all these threads are condensely coiled together, and these coiled fine thread-like structures, they are known as chromatin fibers. And chromatin fibers, they are made up of two organic chemical compounds, and these two organic chemical compounds include DNA and histone proteins. This is combination. Chromatin fibers are resultant of two organic compounds. One is DNA and second one is histone protein. Now, when condensation of chromatin fiber, condensation means thickening. When thickening of chromatin fibers takes place, then only we are able to observe the chromosomes. Chromosomes are not visible with any microscope inside the nucleus. They are always visible in form of chromatin fibers. But if we want to see the chromosomes, generally chromosomes can be seen only during cell division, especially when cell is ready to divide, and especially in metaphase stage. One stage is there in cell division process, that stage is called metaphase stage, and in that stage only we are able to see the chromosome. Now here I have shown you the chromosome, a single chromosome. I told you that chromatin fibers are highly fine thread-like, highly coiled structure. So here I have shown you the diagram of chromosome. Now you can see the outer boundary. The outer boundary of the chromosome, that is called pellicle. And pellicle covers the chromosome externally. Means chromosome is covered externally by a membrane, and that membrane is only known as pellicle. Next, here I have shown you the centromere. This is centromere, and centromere is known as primary constriction. Means suppose any thread-like structure is there and it bends or curves from two sides, then this curved region, here you can see the curve is there, and this curved region is called centromere, or even we call it as primary constriction. Now this centromere, it is covered by another structure, and the structure which covers centromere, that is called kinetochore. It is made up of protein. It is proteinous in nature. That protein, kinetochore, is a protein which covers the centromere. Now inside this, I have shown you matrix. A fluid is also filled inside the chromosome, and that fluid is called matrix. Here student, if we see the length of entire chromosome at the ends, here at the up or terminal end and the lower end, another curve is formed. You can see this curve. This curve is known as secondary constriction. And these curves